Happy Kids TV. The Holy Tales. Well, today's story is about a government official and his son, whom Jesus healed when he was sick.
Is it a sad story? Then I don't want to hear it.
I don't like stories which do not have a happy ending.
Don't worry, Freckles. It isn't a sad story. Hear it, and I'm sure you're going to like it. Jesus traveled from one town to another, teaching and challenging people to follow God. He also healed sick people and did other miracles so that people would believe in him. His very first miracle happened in a place called Cana, where he transformed water to wine at a wedding gathering. There was a powerful and important government official who lived nearby the city. He had a son who was very ill. When the man heard that Jesus was in town, he came to see him. He begged Jesus to come to Capernaum with him to heal his son. The little boy was very sick and was almost dying. Jesus said,
"Do I have to keep doing miracles in order for you people to believe me?"
The man pleaded. He said,
"Please come with me before my son dies."
Jesus replied,
"Go home. Your son will be fine."
The man believed Jesus and started for home. While he was on his way, his servants came and met him. They informed him that his son was much better now and that he did not have to worry. He asked them,
"When did he start improving?"
They told him,
"About 1 o'clock yesterday, his fever suddenly disappeared."
The man realized that it was the exact time when Jesus had told him,
"Go home. Your son will be fine."
Since then, the official, along with everyone in his house, believed and followed Jesus.
That was a nice story. A story with a happy ending. I love it.
See, I told you. You wouldn't be disappointed.
The Holy Tales.
Well, today's story is about how Jesus miraculously healed 10 men who were suffering from a deadly disease.
Wow! That sounds interesting.
Jesus was walking with his disciples to Jerusalem, and like always, a large crowd of people were following him. Just as they were crossing the border between Galilee and Samaria, Jesus saw a group of men standing a little distance away. They were all suffering from the contagious disease of leprosy. So, the law had stated that when a person had this disease, he had to leave his home and live in a leper colony. This group of 10 men that Jesus noticed were all suffering from leprosy. The moment they saw Jesus, they began shouting to him,
"Please! Have mercy on us!"
Jesus very calmly told them to go and show themselves to the priests. The men did not understand why Jesus asked them to do that, but they all took off running towards the temple. As they ran, their bodies were miraculously and completely healed of leprosy. One of the 10 men stopped immediately when he realized that he was healed. He turned around and came back to Jesus. He fell down to his knees and said,
"Praise God! I'm healed!"
He put his face right down on the ground and just kept thanking Jesus for healing him. And this particular man was a Samaritan, not even a Jew. Jesus was thankful for the man's gratitude, but he said,
"Didn't I heal all 10 men? Where are the rest? Why is it just you who returned to thank me? Where are the 9 Jewish men?"
Jesus then told the man to get up and go home. It is his faith in God that cured him.
Nice! Jesus did such wonderful miracles. I love these kind of stories. Me too.
The Holy Tales.
Then let's begin with the story. There were many a times when Jesus appeared to people after he was resurrected. One day, Jesus' disciples were near the Sea of Tiberias when Peter said,
I'm going fishing.
Everyone decided to go with him. So they all went out in a boat and fished all night, but they couldn't catch even a single fish. About dawn, they came back to the shore and saw a man standing on the beach. It was Jesus, but they were unable to recognize him. He called out to them.
My friends, have you caught any fish?
They told him they hadn't.
Well, throw your nets on the right side of the boat, and you shall catch plenty of fish,
he said. They did as he asked, and immediately they caught so many fish that they couldn't even pull in the net. Suddenly, John, another Jesus' disciple, recognized the man on the beach. He cried,
It is Jesus!
When Peter heard that, he jumped into the water and swam to the shore. The others stayed in the boat and brought in all the fish to the shore. When they came to the beach, they saw a small fire burning and fish frying over it. There was bread kept for them too.
Bring me some of the fish you caught,
Jesus said. Simon went to the boat and brought over 100 large fish. It was amazing how the net hadn't torn with so many large fish in it. Jesus finished cooking the food and invited his disciples to come and have breakfast with him.
That was a wonderful, wonderful story, Holy.
I love the story too.
Thank you, Gumbo.
The Holy Tales.
Today's story is about Jesus going home.
Huh? Jesus had a home? No, Jesus' home was heaven. He had no home like us. Am I right, Holy?
Why don't we find that out in the story? Jesus' disciples and his followers were thrilled that he was alive again. They had hoped of a better future because he was alive. They kept asking him questions about when he was going to free Israel and set up his kingdom. They did not clearly understand what Jesus had been actually teaching them.
My Father sets all the plans for his kingdom. I don't even know his plans,
Jesus told them.
When the Holy Spirit comes, you will receive immense power. You will tell people about me, my work, and my teachings. You will tell people right here in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and in the whole world.
Jesus told them. Not long after telling them these things, Jesus was taken up to heaven in front of their eyes while they watched. He disappeared into the clouds, and the disciples strained their eyes trying to see where he had gone. While they were still looking, they suddenly saw two men in bright white robes standing with them. One of the men said,
What are you looking for? Jesus isn't here. He has been taken away and has gone to heaven. Someday, he will come back in just the same way he left.
I'm glad you did. So, Tubby, we can now say that you were right. Jesus did not have a home like us, but his home was heaven.
Thank you for the wonderful story, Holy. Bye. We'll be back soon.
Bye, kids.
To watch more videos, please subscribe.
Plants and trees. On the fourth day, God created the sun to shine in the day, the moon and stars to come out at night. One day, Moses went to Mount Horeb with his sheep. There, God appeared to him as a flame of fire in a bush. Since there was no room anywhere else, they decided to spend the night in a stable. Here, Mary had her baby, Jesus. She wrapped him in a blanket and put him to sleep.
He's got the home.